Hello guys and welcome to the channel everyone. In this video I am going to show you how to create awesome website. By seeing this video you will be able to take your local business online. Now if you are busy and want to hire me, please contact me at support@kiful.com or you can also mail me at kifulofficial@gmail.com. So this is the website that I will be creating today. At first, to create the website, you need domain and hosting. Domain is the name of your website and hosting is the computer where your data, images, files are stored. So at first, to purchase the domain, go to kiful.com/sg. Now click here on web hosting. You can see three plans. If you are just starting the business, I would suggest you to go for this plan, Grow Big. Because with this plan you can host unlimited websites and you will get 20 GB space with just 5.95 per month. Now click here on get plan. Search for the domain name here, whether it is available or not. I will write here wpkiful.com and click on proceed. You can see here, congratulations, wpkiful.com is available. Under account information, fill your email address and password. Under client information, fill your country, city, first name, last name, street, zip code, and phone number. Under payment information, write card number, card expiry date, card holder name, and CVV code. Tick here and click on pay now. After this, you will receive an email and then go to the cPanel. Your cPanel looks slightly different from mine because for this website, I am using different hosting company. Now I will scroll down to find WordPress in this cPanel. Okay, here you can see WordPress. Okay, so I will click here. Now I need to install it. So I will click here on install. Now here you have to choose your domain. Okay, after that let me scroll down. Here you can see site name and site description. Okay, you can change this in the WordPress dashboard later on. Here again you can see admin username and password. Now I'll choose username and then I'll write here password. You need to save this password in the safe place because every time you want to log in to your WordPress dashboard, you need this username and password. Okay, now here you can see admin email. Choose the email that you are accessible now and then scroll down. Here you can see install. Finally, let me click here on install. Now it will take some 5 to 10 seconds to install this WordPress in your website or in your domain name. Okay, now you need this administrative URL every time you log in to your WordPress website. Okay, so I'll click here. Now it will take me to the WordPress dashboard. Now the next step is to install and activate the theme. To install and activate the theme, you can see here appearance section. So I'll click here on themes under the appearance. Okay, and then I'll click here add new to add the new theme. Now here we are going to add OceanWP theme. So I'll search for the theme here, OceanWP, and then so this is the theme that we need. Okay, so I'll click here on install and then I'll click on activate. So you can see here we have successfully installed and activated OceanWP theme. Okay, and we don't need these remaining themes from here. So I'll click here one by one and then I'll delete it, and then I'll delete this remaining 2016 theme from here. Okay, now I'll click here on dismiss this notice button and let me go to the dashboard from here. Okay, after that I'll click here on screen option to make this dashboard more clean. Okay, so I'll disable all these things. Now let me go to the updates button from here. Okay, I'll click here and then click on update plugins. Okay, after that again let me go to the dashboard. Okay, Now let me go to the plugin and then click here and add new, because now I will add some Ocean plugins from here, Ocean WP remaining plugins. Okay, so I'll source here Ocean WP, and then so we'll need this Ocean extra. So I'll click here on install, and then let me scroll down. Okay, here you can see this Ocean WP sticky header. I'll click here on install, and then I'll click here on install now under Ocean social sharing plugin. Okay, I think this much, and then I'll click on activate. I'll right click and click here on activate to all these three plugins to activate it. Okay, you can see all these three plugins has been installed and activated. So I'll cancel it one by one and then go to the dashboard. After that I'll click here on skip setup, because we are going to do it manually. Okay, now I'll click here on dismiss, and then I will minimize this to make the screen more clean, and then I'll click on visit site. So currently this is our website, and it does not look nice because there is no design, no proper font, etc. Okay, but we'll change it and make it more beautiful. First we'll create the page. So I'll click here on add new under the page section. We'll create a home page first. Okay, so I'll write here home under the title section, and then I'll click here on publish. Okay, again I'll click on publish. It has been published into our website. Again I'll click here on add new to create another page, that is shop page. Okay, and then I'll click here on publish. Okay, you can see it has been published into our website. Now in the similar way I will create other three pages. I will create blog page, my account page, and then I will create about us page. But for this I will speed up the process. Okay, so we have successfully created the page. Now let me go to the dashboard. Okay, after that let me go to the pages to see our pages. So we have created these all pages, but we did not create this sample page. So I'll click here on trash to delete this page. Okay, now it has been deleted. Now let me go to the website from here, visit site button. Okay, actually it should be our home page, but currently it is our blog page, so we'll change it to home page. For this let me go to the settings, and then I'll click here on reading under the setting. After that you can see here your latest post. We'll change it to a static page, and then we'll select home under the home page, and we'll select blog under the post page, and then we'll click here on save changes. Okay, after that we need to change the permalink from here. So we'll click here on permalinks, and then I will select your post name, and then I'll click here on save changes. So you can see it has been changed. Now let me go to the website and refresh this page. Okay, you can see here this page has been changed to home page. Previously it was blog page. Okay, on the right hand side you can see this right sidebar. We'll remove this sidebar. For this let me go to the dashboard and then click on pages, all pages. Okay, after that I'll click here on edit under the home page. Okay, now here you can see content layout. I'll select 100% full width and then click on update. Now let me go to the website and then refresh this page. You might see right hand side sidebar might be removed. Okay, it has been removed. Now again let me go to the dashboard to remove this title. Okay, home title. Now I will scroll down, and then you can see a title, and then I'll click here on disable, and then update. Go to the website and refresh the page. Okay, this home title has been removed. Now we need to edit this home page using the Elementor page builder. Okay, so we'll need this plugin called Elementor plugin. So I'll click here on add new under the plugin section. I will search for the plugin, that is Elementor plugin. So this is the plugin. I'll click here on install. Again we'll need this essential add-ons for Elementor, so I'll click on install. Okay, and then I'll click on activate to both of these plugins. So you can see here our both of the plugin has been installed and activated. So I'll remove these tabs, and then I'll go to the pages to edit the home page using Elementor. Okay, after that I'll click here on edit under the home, and then you can see here edit with Elementor button. So I'll click here. Now it will take me to the Elementor page. So you can see here we are currently on the Elementor page. Okay, I will select this single column section. Now I'll click here on plus. Okay, after that I will select this inner section and drag it to this plus icon, and then I will release it here. Now you can see there are two columns inserted here, okay. After that I will select the these 9 dot items or columns for the bigger section and then go to style, because now we are going to add a background image, okay. After that I will click here on plus and then select file, and I will select this image and then click here on open. After that I will click on insert media. Okay, now here on the left hand side you can see position. I will click here and then I will select center. Under attachment I will select fixed. Under repeat I will select no repeat. Under size I will select cover and then click on update. Okay, now again I will click here on plus and then I will select this heading option and then drag it to here. Okay, after that I will remove this text and then I will write here grab life by the handles. Okay, now under the HTML tag I will write here h1 or select h1 and then go to style. Okay, under text color I will select white as the text color. Under typography, under font family I will select Lato, LATO. Under size I will select em and then write here 5 em is the font size, I think 4.7. okay, under the weight I will select 900 pixel. Under transform I will select uppercase. Under style and decoration I will leave it as default. Okay, under line height I will write 1.4 em and letter spacing also 1.4 em, and then I will click on update. Okay, so we have done with the main heading. Okay, again go back and then I will select again heading and then drag it here. Now this is the subheading. Okay, I will write here text is up to 25% off, and then select h4 as the HTML tag, and then go to style, select color as white for the text color. Okay, under typography, size I'll write here 2 em, and weight is 700 pixel. Transform to uppercase, and line height is I think 3. Okay, and font family is Lato, and finally I'll click here on update. Okay, now the next step is to add the button. Okay, to add the button, first I will click and drag this inner section element to here. Now here you can see two columns. I'll click on the plus icon of this first column to add the button. Okay, now here you can see button element. I'll click and drag this element into the plus icon here. Now you can see button appears. Okay, I'll change the text here to shop now, and then I'll go to the style, and I'll change the typography. Okay, I'll click here and then I'll change the font family as Lato, size is 1 em. I'll change the weight to 700 pixel and transform to uppercase. I will leave style and decoration as it is, and then I'll click here and write here 2 as the letter spacing. Okay, now again let me change weight to 900 pixel here. Okay, now let me go to the color. First I'll change background color to white, and I will change text color to black here. Okay, now after that I'll click here on update. Now let me go to the border type is solid. I'll change width to 2 pixel from all the sides, and then border radius, border color I'll write here, I'll choose white, and border radius I'll write here 2 from all the side. Okay, padding I'll first unlink this from here, and then I'll write here 15 35 15 and 35. Okay, now I'll click here on update. Now here you can see there is no any hover effect. Okay, I'll make hover effect here. First to make this, I'll click here on hover, and then I'll change the text color to white. Okay, now and you can see here you cannot see the text. Okay, first I'll change the border color to again white, and then I will change the background color. Okay, again you cannot see the text. I'll change the background color as transparent. For that I'll write here RGBA and 255, 255, 255, 0, and then I'll close the bracket. Okay, now you can see here it is transparent color, and then I'll click on update. Now you can see there is over effect. You can see transparent background color. Okay, okay, now let me quickly open the new tab from here, and then I'll go to my website. Okay, here I have to reduce the column percentage. Okay, for this I will click and drag it to the left, and then I will make it here 36%. Okay, 36%, and then I will click here on update. Okay, now again let me go to the website and refresh the page. You can see it has been reduced to 36%. Okay, now after that I will click here on navigator, and then I will click here on section. Okay, because now I am going to add the padding. Okay, after that I will click here on advanced, and then I will add the padding. First I will unlink this, and I will write here 100 pixel from the top and 100 pixel from the bottom. After that I will click on update, and then I will go back. Okay, now again I will click here on navigator, and then click on section. Okay, after that again let me go to the advanced. Okay, I will reduce the padding to 70 pixel on the top and click on update. Now let me close this navigator from here. After that I will click on this 6 dot, and then I will change the layout to full width, and then click on update. After that I will go to the website and refresh the page. You can see this main heading has been 100% full width. Okay, now you can see this shop now button. Okay, I will again change that shop now button. First of all I will duplicate this column 2 times. Okay, I will make 2 duplicate columns, and then I will click on 6 dot, and then I will change this box to full width and click on update. Now let me go to the website and refresh the page. You can see this shop now button has been 100% full width. Okay, again let me go to the dashboard from here, because now we are going to change the header. After that go to the all pages, and I will click here on edit under the home page. Now I will change the header, so I will click here on transparent under the header style, and then I will click on disable, and here I will click here on enable under the display header, and click on update. After that I will go to the website from here, visit site button. Okay, but here you can see there are 2 errors. The first one is, you can see site identity named my blog. Okay, we'll remove this. And the second one is white colored header border, you can see here. So I'll remove this from the customization. So I'll go to the customization page. Okay, after that I'll click here on header, and then I'll click on general. After that I'll untick this header border button, and then click on publish. After that I'll go to the website and refresh the page. You can see header border has been removed. Now we will remove this site title called my blog. For this let me go back, again go back, and then here you can see site identity. I'll click here, and then I'll delete this site title from here, and then click on publish. After that I'll go to the website and refresh the page. You can see site title would be removed. Now next part is to decrease this column percentage. Okay, for this I'll go to the Elementor page, and I'll click and drag this column percentage from here. Okay, that's fine. And then I'll click on update. Now go to the website and refresh the page. Now you can see it looks more beautiful than previous one. Okay, again let me go to the customization to add the menu. Okay, now we'll add the menu. For this I'll click here on menus. After that I'll click on create new menu. Now I have to give the menu name. After that I have to select the main, and then click on next. Now I'll click here on add items, to add the items, because we had already created the menu name. Okay, I will add home, about us, my account, blog and shop. After this I will click on publish to publish this into the website. Now I will rearrange this menu. Okay, I will bring this shop to the second position, and blog to the third position. Again I will bring this my account to the third position. Okay, and then I will click on here publish at the top. Let me click here and publish. Okay, now you can see here these menus has been added into my home page. Okay, after that let me go to the Elementor, and then go to the dashboard from here. After that let me go to the pages. Now we'll add, or we'll change the color of only the home page. Okay, after that I'll click on edit, and then you can see here header. So I'll click on header, and then I'll change the link color to white. Okay, I'll select the white color from here, and then I'll click here on link color over color. I'll select the mixture of gray and white. Okay, I think F2 will be fine. Okay, after that I'll click on update, and then go to the website from here, visit site link. Okay, and then I'll You can see here this color has been changed to white. Previously it was gray color, now it is white color. Okay, now here you can see there is search icon. We'll remove this search icon. For this, let me go to the customization page and go back again. Let me go back. Okay, here you can see header. I'll click on header and then I'll click on menu. Okay, let me scroll down to the button. Okay, here you can see search icon style. Okay, and then you can see a drop down. I'll click on drop down and click on disabled. After that, I'll click here on publish and then go to the website and refresh the page. You can see this search icon would be removed. Okay, first I'll delete these tabs from here and then I'll go to the Elementor page. Okay, and then I'll scroll down. Okay, here you can see plus icon. I will click here on plus icon and then select this single column to add another element. Okay, after that I will click here on plus and then again click and drag this inner section element into the plus icon. Okay, now here you can see there are two columns. I will delete this second column. For this I will right click and then click on delete. Okay, here you can see it has been deleted. Again I will click here on plus and then drag this adding element into the plus icon. Okay, now I will delete this text and then I'll write here a bike for every rider and then I'll change it to h3 html tag and make it center alignment. After that I'll go to the style, change the text color to black, and then I'll click here on typography and change font family to Lato, size to 30 pixel, weight to 700 pixel, transform to uppercase. Okay, after that I will click here on update. Okay, now again let me go back. Now I will add divider element. Here you can see divider. I will click and drag this divider element here. After that I will change the weight to 3 and then color to black. Okay, after that width to 150 pixel, and I will make it center alignment and I will reduce the gap to 5 and then click on update. After that I will go to the advanced and change margin to minus 13 pixel and after that I will click here on update. Okay, now again let me click on this text and go to the style. After that go to the typography and change letter spacing to minus 0.5 em and then click on update. Okay, after that again I will click on this 6 dot and then go to the advanced and I will add the padding to 100 pixel on the top and 100 pixel on the bottom. After that again I will click here on update. Okay, now the next step is to add the product. Okay, to add the product we need to install and activate the WooCommerce plugin. So to install and activate WooCommerce plugin, let me go to the add new under the plugin section. Here I will search for the plugin, that is WooCommerce, and this is the plugin that we need. I will click here on install now and then I will click here on activate. Here I have to configure the WooCommerce settings. Okay, first I will choose Australia under the store based, and address as Ocean Street and city as Sydney, state to New South Wales, postcode or zip code to 2000, and here you can see what type of product do you plan to sell. I will click here and I plan to sell physical products, so I'll click on physical products and then click on let's go. Okay, now here you can see payment methods or payment gateway. We will do this at the end of the video. Okay, I'll choose PayPal here and then click on continue. Here I have to configure this shipping method. I'll choose flat rate inside the Australia as $5 shipping charge and location not covered by your other zone. I'll choose free shipping and click on continue. Okay, I will click here on skip this setup because we don't want this. Again here I will click here on skip this setup. Okay, after that I will click here on visit dashboard. Okay, so this is our dashboard. Now let me go to the settings under the WooCommerce. Okay, so this is the general settings and everything seems good. So let me move to the product. Okay, it is also good. We don't have to change anything. So let me go to the shipping. Okay, we'll do this shipping at the end of the video. Okay, now let me go to the accounts and privacy. Here also we don't have to change anything. So again, let me move to another section, that is emails. Okay, it looks good. Now let us move to another section, that is integration. Again, let us move to the advanced. Okay, here we have to make some changes. Here you can see there are four pages: cart page, checkout page, my account page, and terms and condition page. We have not created these pages, so first we have to create the page. So I will click here on pages to create the page. Okay, after that I will click here on add new. Now first you can see there is cart page. Okay, so we will create the cart page. Now let me move to the pages and I will write here cart. Now again let me move to the WooCommerce settings. Here when I hover mouse over this question mark, you can see WooCommerce underscore cart is the short code. We have to insert the short code here. Okay, so I will write here square bracket WooCommerce underscore cart, and I will close the square bracket, and then I will click here on publish. Okay, it has been published. Now again let me click here on add new to add another page, that is checkout page. Okay, we will add this checkout page. In the similar way, I will create other pages like cart page, terms and condition page, my account page, but for this I will speed up the process. Okay, okay, again I will remove this tab from here, and then I will refresh this page to add terms and conditions under the page setup. Now here you can see terms and conditions. Okay, I will click here and then choose terms and conditions, and then I will scroll down to click here on save changes. The settings has been saved. Now I will click here on general to add tags. After that I will scroll down, and then you can see here enable tax rate and calculations. I will tick here and then click on save changes again. Now there will be tax options at the top here. I will click here and then I will click on standard rates. Okay, I will write here AU for Australia, and then I will write here 10% under the rate, because here is 10% GST, and then click on save changes. So we have successfully added the tax rate. Now the next step is to add the products. To add the product, I will click here on add new under the product section. Okay, now here I have to write the product name. I will write here mountain bike as the product name. Here I have to write the long description about the product. Okay, you can see I have just written it quickly, and then I will scroll down. You can see here product data. Under product data you can see simple, variable, group, external or affiliate product. I will select simple product. Under regular price I will write here $500, and under tax status taxable, under tax class standard. Okay, now let's go to inventory. I will write here Kiful 1 is the SKU. SKU means unique code or unique number given to every product. Okay, now let's go to shipping. Here I will write 12 kg for the weight, and for the dimension I will write here 150 cm length, 184, and then 100 is the height. Okay, now let me scroll down. Here you can see short description about the product. Okay, you can write that. Now let me click here on set product image. After that I will click on upload file, select file. I will select this image and then click on submit, and then click on set product image. So this is our product image. Now here you can see product tags. Okay, you can write here as for your product. I will write here mountain bike, and you have to give comma, and then I will write bike, and then click on add. After that I will click here on add new category for the product. I will write here mountain bike, and then click here on add new category. You can see it has been added. Now again I will write here speedy mountain bike, and under the parent category I will select mountain bike, and then again click here on add new category. You can see both of the categories has been added. Now finally I will click here on publish. Okay, the product has been published into our website. Now let me click here to see our product into the website. So this is our product. Now let me scroll down. Here you can see description about the product. So these are the descriptions that we wrote down. Now here you can see additional information. Under additional information you can see weight and dimension. Under reviews, the buyer can give review for your product. I'll for example I'll give 5-star, and then write here quick bike, and then click on submit. Okay, so here you can see product review. You can increase the number of product by clicking here on the plus button. Now here at the left hand side you can see there is sidebar. We will quickly remove that sidebar at the end of this video. Okay, now let me go to the product page again. Again I will click here on add new to add another product. So in the similar way I will add other 10 products, but for this I will speed up the process. Now I will click here on all products, and you can see here these are the 10 products that we just created and published into our website. Okay, now I will remove this tab from here and then go to the Elementor page. Okay, after that I will refresh this page. Now I will slightly scroll down, and on the left hand side these elements, I will scroll down, and here you can see this shortcode element. I will click and drag this element here. Okay, now here I have to enter the WooCommerce shortcode for the products. For this I will open the new tab and go to the documentation page of WooCommerce. So this is the documentation page. You can see, or you can learn from this page how to upload or how to publish the product into the website on the basis of date, ID, menu order, popularity, featured product, or on the basis of categories. Okay, for this video I will display the products on the basis of category. So I will copy this shortcode from here. I will copy it and then I will go to the Elementor page and then I will paste it here. Now here I have to remove and paste my category here. For this I will open the product page. Here you can see categories. Okay, here you can see mountain bike as the category name. So I will copy this mountain bike category from here and then I will paste it here. Similarly, I will remove this t-shirts from here, and then I will go to the product page again and I will copy this second category named speedy mountain bike, and then go to the Elementor page and then I will paste it here. After that I will click here and apply. Now here you can see all these products that are listed on the basis of mountain bike category and speedy mountain bike category will be displayed here. Okay, after that I will click here and update. Okay, so these are the products that are listed on the basis of categories. Now I'll remove this tab from here and then I'll again open the tab and go to the website to see these products into our website. After that I'll scroll down. So these are the products we just created. Now here you can see there is some gap on the left hand side and right hand side. Okay, we'll remove this. To remove this I'll go to the Elementor and then I'll slightly scroll up and then I'll click here on 6 dot. After that you can see here content with boxed. I'll select full width and click on update. After that I'll go to the website and refresh the page. You will see this gap will be removed. Okay, you can see here now there is you cannot see any gap between this divider and the product image, so we'll create some gap here. Okay, for this I'll click here on pencil icon and then go to the advanced. First I'll unlink this and then write here 50 pixel on the top. After that click on update. Okay, now again I'll go to the content and I'll write here product limit is 10, so that there will be maximum 10 product listed on this particular section. Here I will write columns is equal to 5, so that there will be 5 products in each of the column. Okay, now refresh the page. You will see there will be 5 products in both of the column. Okay, so these are the 5 products. Okay, now I will add another section that is call to action section. For that I will go to the Elementor page again. Now I will go back from here and then I will click and drag this inner section element here. After that I will go to the advanced section and then I will add a padding of 100 pixel on the top and 100 pixel on the bottom. After that I will click here on update. Now I will go to the style to add the background image. After that I will click here on brush icon and click here on choose image, upload file, select files. I will select this image and click here on open. After that I will click here on insert media. You can see the image has been uploaded. Now I will click here on center under the position. Attachment is fixed, repeat is no repeat, and size is cover. After that I will again click here on update. Now I will click here on plus icon and then I will click and drag this heading element into the plus icon. Now I will remove this text and then I will write here go the distance. After that I will go to the style and I will change the text color to white. I will click here on typography, change the font family as Lato, size as 41 pixel and weight to 700 pixel, transform to uppercase. After that I will change letter spacing to 0.5 em. And then I'll click on update. Now again I'll go back again go back, and then I will click and drag this heading element here. Again I will change the text, and then I will write here, get a great ride with top bike. And then I will change S3 as the HTML tag. Go to the style, change the text color to white. Under typography, I will change the font family to Lato and size to 30 pixel. After that, weight to 700 pixel, transform to uppercase, and line height and letter spacing to 1.3 and 2 mm respectively. After that, I will click here on object. Now again I will click here on typography and change the transform to default. Again click here on update. After that, I will go back, again go back, and then I will click and drag this heading element to here. Again I will change the text here. I will write here, boost your fitness up to 25% off and use code KIFUL20. After that, I will change the HTML tag to paragraph and then click here on update. Go to the style, change the text color to white. Go to the typography, change font family to Lato, size to 14 pixel, weight to bold, and letter spacing and line height to 2 mm respectively. After that, I'll go to the advanced, add margin of 80 pixel on the top and click on update. Now again I'll click here on 6 dot and go to the layout. After that, I'll change it to full width and click on update. Now let me go to the website and refresh the page. I'll scroll down. So this is our call to action. Now we'll add here button. To add the button, I'll go to the Elementor and then I'll go back from here. You can see our button element. I'll click and drag this element here. Okay, now I'll scroll up from here and I'll copy this button. I'll right click here and click here and copy. I'll go down and paste it here. Okay, I'll remove this previous button and I'll change the text to buy now, and then I'll go to the style. We'll make exactly opposite of the text color and over effect. Okay, first I'll change the text color to white and background color to transparent, that is RGBA 255, 255, 255, 0. I'll close the bracket and I'll go to the over and change the text color to black and background color to white. I'll scroll this up. You can see there is beautiful over effect. After that, I'll click here on update. Now let me go to the website and refresh the page. So you can see this is our call to action with beautiful over effect on the button. Now I'll go to the Elementor page. Now I will add another section into the website, that is feature section. So I'll click and drag this inner section element here. After that, I'll go to the advanced and I'll untick here and then write here 100 pixel margin at the top and then click on update. After that, I'll click here on plus icon and then scroll down this left hand side elements and then click and drag this icon box into the plus icon. After that, I'll click here on icon library. And then I will search here globe. I will select this one image, click on insert, and then click here on update. I will change this title to old wide delivery, and I will change this text or description text, and then click on update. Now I will go to the style. I will change the icon color to black and icon size to 45. Icon spacing to minus 20 and then click on update. Now again I will click here on content, change the title color to black and description color to black, and then again I will click here on typography, change the font family to Lato and then size to 18 pixel, and click here on update. Now again I will click here on typography under the description, change the font family to Lato and click on update. Now again I will go back from here and then click here on content, and again on the style I will change this spacing to 0 and then click here on update. Now again I will duplicate this section or duplicate this column 3 times. Again I will duplicate this one. After that I will delete this 5th column, and then I will click here on 2nd column, and then I will change this icon. I will click here icon library, I will search here user, okay, I will select this one and then click on insert. Now I will change this title to customer care and then click on update. Now similarly I will click here on icon, change this icon to redo. I will select this one, click on insert, change the title to refund policy, and then click on update, and then go to the worldwide delivery. I will search here lock and then select this one, click on insert. I will write here secure payments under the title and then click on update. I will go to the website and then I will scroll down. After that I will refresh this page. Okay, you can see here feature sections has been added and published into our website. Now we will add last section in our home page, that is footer section. To add the footer section, I will click here on customize and I will go to the customization page. After that I will scroll down and then I will click here on menus, because we will add menu first. Okay, now I will click here and create new menu. I have to write the menu name here. I will write here widget 1 menu and then click here on next. After that I will click here on add items. Here I have to add the new page because we have not created these pages. Okay, so first I will write here about us page and then click here on add, and then contact us page. After that I will click on add, and then terms and conditions page, privacy policy, and job opportunity, click on add, bicycle hire, and then click on add. After that I will click here on publish. Okay, now I will go back again. I will click here and create new menu, because now I will create another menu. I will write here widget 2 menu as the menu name. Okay, and then I will click here on next. After that I will again click here on add items, and then I have to write the page name here. First I will write help center and then click on add, and then order status, click on add, payment methods, click on add, and then shipping. After that returns, and then finally I will write here warranty and then click on add. Finally I will click here on publish. Okay, now I will refresh this whole page. Okay, after that I will scroll down. Now I will add the footer. Okay, to add the footer I will click here on widgets and then click on footer 1 and then add a widget. After that I will click here on custom menu. Okay, now I will select the menu here. I will select widget 1 menu, and then you can see widget 1 menu has been added. I will write the title for the menu, that is company info. Okay, and then I will click here on publish. Similarly I will go back and then click on footer 2 to add footer. Again click on add a widget and select custom menu. I will select widget 2 menu as the menu name, and then I will write here help as the title, and then click on publish. After that again I will go back from here and then click here on footer 3. After that click on add a widget. Now I will scroll down and then select social icons. Here I have to enter the social media link here. Okay, first I will add here Twitter link. You have to write your Twitter, Facebook, Instagram link here. Okay, now after that I will scroll up and then I will click here and then select colored. Now similarly I will change the transition to float, and I will remove this title and then write here connect with us, and then click on publish. Okay, you can see it has been published. Now let me go back and then I'll click here on footer 4 and then click on add a widget. Scroll down, I'll select this image and then click on add image, upload file, select files. Okay, I'll select this image and then click on open. After that, I will click here on add to widget. You can see image has been added into the footer section. Now I will write here title as secure online shopping. Okay, I will remove this online shopping and then write here secure payments. Okay, and then I will click here on publish. So we have done with the footer section. Now again, let me go to the website and then I will scroll down and refresh this page. Okay, you can see our footer has been added into our website. Now here at the bottom, you can see footer bottom. Okay, I will change this. To change this, again I will go to the customize page and then go back from here. Again, I will go back here. You can see footer bottom. I will click here and then I will change this copyright text. I will write here copyright and 2019 Kiful. And then I will click here on publish and go to the website and refresh the page. You will see footer bottom will be changed. Okay, you can see it has been changed. So finally, in this way, we have completed with our home page. So you can see here we have completed our home page. Now I will scroll up. Now the next step is to add the logo. Okay, we'll add the logo on the left hand side of the page. For this, I'll go to the customize page and then I'll go back from here. Now I will click here on header button. Okay, after that I will click here on logo and then click on select logo and then upload file, select files. Now here you can see there are two logo, one is white color and another one is gray color. I will use gray color logo for all the page or in the general, and I will only use white color logo for the home page only. Okay, after that I will click on select here. If you want, you can crop the image or you can skip the cropping. Now I will scroll up. Now currently you cannot see the logo, you can only see after I refresh this page. Okay, now I will click here on dashboard. After that I will click here on edit page, because now we are going to add white color logo only for the home page. Now here you can see logo option. I will click here and then click on add image. Okay, now I will go to the upload file, select file, and then I will select this white color logo only for the home page. Okay, after that click on open and then set as image. So you can see white color logo has been uploaded, and click on update. Now I will click here on view page. Okay, you can see our logo has been uploaded and published into our website. Now I will go to the shop page to see the logo, that is gray color logo. Okay, now here you can see our logo has been published in all the pages of our website. So we have finished creating the logo. Now the next step is to create the contact us page. To create the contact us page, I will click here on page under the new. After that I will write here contact us under the title and then click here on publish. Again I will click on publish. After that I will click here on view page. Now here you can see there is right hand sidebar. We will remove this sidebar. Okay, to remove the sidebar, again I will go to the page here and then I will click here on content layout and click on full width, and then I will cancel this and click here on update. After it is updated, I will go to the contact us page and refresh the page. You will see this sidebar would be removed. Okay, now here you can see it has been removed. Now again let me go to the page and then I will click here on edit with Elementor. Now it will take me to the Elementor page. So now creating contact us page from the beginning would take a lot of time. So to make this video shorter, I have already created contact us page. I just need to import that page here. Okay, now if you want to download and import that same page, you can just click on the link in the description below. Contact us page will be automatically downloaded when you click on that link. So if you are watching this video, click here on the second link and then let me click here on save. You can see here at the bottom of the page downloading has started. Now again I'll go to the Elementor page. Okay, now I will click here on folder icon to add that contact us template. Okay, after that I will click here on insert or import template and then click here on select files. Now I will select this contact us file that we just downloaded from that YouTube link. Okay, after that you can see here it is our contact us template, and click here on insert. Okay, it has been inserted into our contact us page. So this is our contact us page. You can see here there are two maps. You can see here there is message, social media link, map, location of our shop or location of our store. Okay, you can see here email address and phone number below that email address. You can change that email address by clicking that. Okay, I will write here my own email address and click here on update. So this is our social media link. Now here you have to insert the form, okay, message form. To insert the form, first you need to open the new tab and go to the dashboard. After that, click here on plugins and go to the add new, because now we are going to add contact form 7 plugin. After that, search for the plugin here, contact form 7. Okay, this is the plugin that we need. Click on install now. After it is installed, click on activate. Okay, you can see contact form 7 has been installed and activated. Now here on the left hand side you can see contact, so click on that contact. Okay, so this is our contact form. Now and the name of the form is contact form 1. Now I'll go to the Elementor and then I'll go back from here. Again I'll go back here under the search widget. I'll search for the form FORM. You can see here EA contact form 7. So I'll click and drag this form here. Okay, now here I'll select the form as contact form 1, and then you can see form has been inserted. You can change the design and layout of the form from the style and advanced option. I'll only change this button design. Okay, so I'll click here on style and then I'll scroll down. Here you can see submit button. I'll click here. Okay, and then I will make it center alignment. After that I will click here on background color, and then I will change it to gray color. Okay, now again let me scroll down. After that I will add the border radius of 15 pixel from all the sides, and then finally I will click here on update. Okay, our contact form is ready. So now again I will close these tabs. Okay, I will open the new tab and go to the dashboard again. Okay, I will go to the dashboard by clicking here. Now I will go to the appearance and click here on menus. We will add contact us as the main menu. Okay, so here you cannot see contact us. I will select contact us from here and then click on add to menu. After that you can see contact us has been added. Then click here on same menu. Again go to the website and refresh the page. You can see contact us has been added into our main menu. Now again let me go to the contact us page by clicking here. So you can see this is our final contact us page. Okay, here you can see there are two store location, and the customer can message you from this contact us form. Again let me go to the home page. Okay, now I will change the size of these main menus. Okay, to change the size I will click here and customize, and then I will go to the customization page. On the left hand side you can see typography. I will click here on typography and then click on main menu. Now here you can see size is 13 pixel. Okay, I'll write here 17 pixel. Okay, I'll write here 16 pixel, and then click here on publish. Now let me go to the website and refresh the page. You will see size has been increased. Okay, now I'll close these tabs and then go to the dashboard. I'll go to the dashboard from here, and then I'll go to WooCommerce and click here on settings. Now click here on payments. Okay, here you can see we have enabled two payment method, that is Stripe and PayPal. In alternative to PayPal you can also use Tooth Checkout. Okay, if you want to learn how to integrate Tooth Checkout with your WordPress website, you can open my YouTube channel and you can go to the playlist from here, and you can find Tooth Checkout complete videos here. There are total 6 videos. Okay, you can watch these videos and you can integrate Tooth Checkout into your website. For this tutorial I'll only use PayPal, and then I'll scroll down. Okay, and then click here on save changes. Okay, now let me go to the website from here. Okay, so this is our website. We have completed everything. Everything means we have done with the home page and shop page. Okay, now I'll open this website with another browser. Okay, we have completed home page, shop page, and we have integrated payment methods into our website. Okay, now I will choose any one of the product and then show you how you can place the order. Okay, suppose you can click here on quick view, or you can also click here on add to cart. I'll click here on quick view. Okay, I'll close this, and again I'll click here on add to cart. Now it has been added to the cart. I will scroll up. You can see it has been added. Now I'll click here on checkout, so that we can go to the checkout page of our website. So this is the checkout page. Okay, here I have to write my first name, last name. I have to select the country from here, street address, and then suburb, state, postcode and email address. Okay, I'll write here email address. Now here you can see the price of the product is $1,000 and everything included, the total price becomes $1,105. Okay, now I will select here and click on continue to payment. It will take me to the PayPal PayPal checkout form. Here I have to write my password and email address and click here on login to make the payment. But for now I'll click here on cancel and it will return back to me to the cart page. So with this we have completed our complete website. I hope you learned something from this video. If you need any help, you can comment down below or you can message me. I have given my contact details in the description below.